All right. So here's another thing. Santa Inc. is this new show on HBO with Seth Rogan and Sarah Silverman. Have you watched this at all?
I didn't know. No.
Santa!
Yeah. So they're ramping up their efforts on Christmas here, and this is Santa Inc. It has the lowest audience score that I've ever seen on Rotten Tomatoes, 3%.
Oh, wow.
No critic scores yet because they just said, well, we just can't compete. And then I do have, look.
That's incredible.
Yeah. Our work is done for us. They already gave it 3.
I watched 4 episodes, so before we get to that, let's watch the a lot of people are upset about it. Of course, Seth Rogen and Sarah Silverman are saying the only reason people are upset is that they are white supremacists.
Oh, boy.
One does. That's just because my comedy's gotten really lazy since the pandemic. Nobody wants to watch a 50-year-old dude smoke weed. No, it's true.
Yeah, I'm depressed about it.
Again.
So let's watch the trailer now and see why everyone is upset with these folks in Hollywood taking aim at Christmas.
When you're a kid, there's only one day a year more special than any other day, and that day is Christmas. And we are the magic behind that day. So let's get these f***ing kids some f***ing presents.
Oh, Tony Avenue. Oh, yeah.
Kids movie.
Say F word, laugh, laughs.
Man in snowbiz, good golly, he's jolly. Our own Santa Claus!
Hey, Merry Christmas. Whoa, you're on my naughty list.
Good news, sir. More American kids believe in you than they do in vaccines or the Holocaust.
That's great. I mean, disheartening for America, but great for us.
Oh, wise advice from a Canadian.
I'm here from the North Pole Times. Have you decided who will succeed you as Santa Claus?
Subtext, Santa's old and knocking on death's door. F*** you. Good question. I'll give it some serious thought. Ha ha ho ho ho. Bye.
There have been many Santa Clauses throughout history. Some were loved, others loathed. But the position of Santa has mostly been a white man's game.
Oh, boy.
Exactly.
Yes.
Crazy. Things have got to change.
No, they don't.
It's not crazy.
You're purple.
If I die, get rid of my porn!
What? I want to be the next Santa. If this is your dream, you have to at least make your case, bitch.
You got to get intimate with that jolly bitch.
I know you're right, but do you really have to call me bitch every time you say something?
Yes, bitch, because it's empowering to call you bitch, bitch.
Oh. Let's I would hunt that deer.
Yes.
Santa and the boar.
I wouldn't even hunt it. I'd run it over with my car.
White. They play golf.
And leave it alive.
Yeah. Smoke cigars. Say things like, don't ever marry your mistress.
Just so you know, the women of the North Pole make fun of one of
I don't even get these jokes.
Have fun wondering whose it is.
Maybe I'm just stupid, but I don't get these jokes.
Go out with these guys. You know, shoot the shit, do shots, shoot shots of shit.
Aw, it's my favorite Christmas ideas, song. Really.
It is a great song.
Really be the face of Christmas?
This is where there's a mismatch between the enthusiasm of the song and the boring content on screen.
Oh, yeah.
I'll be named successor, die trying.
Well, this is a show. This isn't a movie.
Yeah, it's,
a,
it's an
rid
eight
of.
Christmas.
In 2 hours, this is full on a show.
Night. What?
Sorry, no, you go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
No, I'm just saying, what's the plot?
She wants to be the new Santa because, unfortunately, old white men have played Santa, and that needs to change.
Just wanted to see.
Yeah.
So now a little Jewish elf.
Hope I've briefed you.
You have. Yeah. I just wanted to make sure I had that correct, and I don't know. I started getting a migraine.
Yeah. Well, the comments have been turned off on the trailer, so that's a really good sign.
Yeah. Yeah. You can't see the dislikes.
Yeah,
so.
And just keep in mind, this is the reason on YouTube dislikes are no longer publicly available. Hey, you don't see any independent content creators saying, do away with the dislikes. It's HBO. It's ABC. Yeah. It's Viacom. It's NBC Universal. By the way, people we've all been in some sort of litigation with at some point in time, just to be clear, it gives us a leg up because we have the power of you right now watching, just like Snopes having to re-fact check their fact check and the fact and the check and the fact that's fact checked.
Smash the like button.
Smash the like button if you're watching to let us know that you'll go over there and, smash the dislike button. Yeah. Here's the thing. They get to see it.
Yeah.
They get to see it. Yeah. We don't get to see it publicly. But deep down, they know.
It's a message straight to them.
And this is my issue with it. Look, first off, I don't know why everything has to be you're a comedian.
Yeah.
I'm a comedian. I understand that being subversive, that taking topics and sort of switching them around. Why do we have to do that with something that's designed to be wholesome for kids with Christmas? And look, let me just present a hypothetical situation here, if I may. The reason this rubs people the wrong way is, first off, when you watch this, I've watched 4 episodes. They revile Christmas. The yeah. disdain for Christmas is very, very clear. It's not done with love. It's not done with a wink and a nod. If you look at the classics that people love, A Christmas Story, very funny.
Yeah.
You look
at Silent Night, Deadly Night.
Yes, precisely. Black Christmas. Krampus. No, but Christmas Vacation, these are still yeah. funny films.
Christmas Vacation is getting a re-release.
But it's a yeah. love letter to Christmas.
Yeah.
But look, these... Okay. How would you feel, what would you think, if a bunch of Gentiles made a film about Hanukkah and took a steaming dump on everything that it was? Do you think that would go over well? These are people who know nothing about Christmas, who don't celebrate Christmas. Sarah Silverman, Seth Rogan, and by the way, he co-produces with Evan Goldberg, this guy who did Pineapple Express and I don't know, Sausage Party. His big claim to fame is knowing Seth Rogan in high school. Well, by the way, his wife writes an episode of this series. So it's like, hey, I know Seth Rogan from high school. Hey, sweetheart, you can be a professional comedy writer. And HBO just said, sounds great. Signed off on it.
Yeah. Good to go.
This is the incestuous, it's such an incestuous gene pool in Hollywood. It's almost the CIA or royal family.
Well, and I think they totally missed about like 3%, obviously, right? What we want is more stuff like Home Alone and Christmas Vacation. Like, we want stuff that throws back to a time when we didn't have to worry about you trying to say Santa has to be non-white. Santa
and not a remake.
Non-male.
Even think
exactly,
about, like,
not just a remake, not something lazy, but something fun. Like, something that is like, I don't want the woke crap that I have to deal with in every other part of my life. Please give
think
me
about
something.
This Bad Santa. It's a raunchy movie.
Exactly.
It's an adult movie. It's funny movie, but it still has reverence for
and it
Christmas
has heart.
And the whole idea. And it has heart. This has no heart. This
right.
is just
it's
malice
so lazy.
And evil. It's
Scrooged like, is a very dark. You know,
yes,
hey, comment. You guys, let
dark.
Me know.
Yeah.
I've experienced that most women don't like Scrooge because they find it a little bit dark. My wife doesn't.
It's pretty dark.
A lot of women are like, that's not. But I know a lot of guys like it. That's my favorite, Scrooge. I would have to put that right up there. If
it's
not number one, it's interchangeable. But that's pretty dark.
That and Christmas Vacation.
Yeah,
definitely mine.
Mine would be that. Mine would be Christmas. Christmas Story.
That's not.
I disagree,
list.
But
well, that's okay. You can be wrong.
I'd rather watch this thing.
Definitely Die Hard.
No, than a Christmas Story?
No, I'd rather watch my favorite aunt.
Hey, you know what? You better watch your tongue. Watch your mouth.
Died.
Watch Louder with Crowder live Monday through Thursday, 10 a.m. Eastern.